In times of uncertainty and chaos, it is imminent that we abide in Christ. I always knew I needed to spend time with God and that it was important to read the Bible. But then I read John 15, verse 6, where it says, "When anyone does not abide in me, in Jesus, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and they throw them into the fire and they are burnt." Now, right from the get-go, I want to define abiding, what abiding means. Abiding means to spend quality time with Jesus. It means to spend time in the Word, to read the Bible, to pray, to build a relationship with God, to stay in His presence, to talk to the Holy Spirit and talk to Him about the Word and about God and about what's going on in your life. That is what abiding in Christ means, to spend time with Him and in His Word. Now, if we go back to verse 6, Jesus is basically saying here, if you do not build the relationship with me, you will be pushed out. You will be cast out. But furthermore, you will not just be cast out, but you will spiritually dry up and you will die. But it doesn't stay there. He goes even a step further and says, after you dried spiritually, in the end, ultimately, you will be gathered and you will be thrown into the fire. Now, he's talking about people that are supposed to abide in him. Who are those people? Those are not the people that don't know him. Those are the people that know him, that are supposed to know the truth. People that are supposed to abide in him. Those are Christians, followers of Christ. Just supporting for this, we can read in the same chapter in verse 2, where it says that there are branches, Christians, that are in him, in Christ, that do not bear fruit. And it says that those will be taken away. That's strong stuff. That is serious. But that also shows how important it is to Jesus, how important it is to build this relationship with him, how important it is, especially in these times that we're in right now in 2020 and going from here, that we abide in him, that we build this relationship. Now, this video is about how do we abide in him? How does this abiding work? And I already mentioned it a little bit, praying, reading the Bible, but I want to go a little deeper. Now, when I say abiding is about prayer, reading the Word, building the relationship, I don't want you to think of checklist, I need to fulfill a certain standard, I need to do certain acts to produce God to love me. That is not what abiding means and abiding in Christ is all about. When you look in verse 9 in chapter 15 of John, you can see what Jesus actually means with this abiding. He says, "As the Father loved me, I also loved you. Abide in my love." Meaning to say, abiding in him means abiding in his love. And this abiding thing is actually about love. Now, I don't mean this fluffy, puffy love that makes you feel so good, oh, the presence of God. That's not the love I'm talking about. It's the love in action that laid down his life for you and called you friend before you even knew him, that gave everything for you so that you could walk free, not bound by sin anymore, but being delivered and healed and restored, living a life as a son and not as an orphan anymore, living as a follower of Christ in the power of God, which is all grounded and founded on the love of God. That's what Jesus wants you to abide in, not the huffy fluffy awful good love, but the love that takes action, that gives himself for you, that takes time for you when you say, "Here I am, God, I surrender, I repent, I'm sorry." That steps down and says, "Here I am, I forgive you, I love you, let's go, let's get this thing going." That's the love I'm talking about. That's what Jesus wants you to abide in. Now again, I don't mean through, okay, I have to pray, I have to read the Bible, I have to do ministry, I have to do deliverance and healing and check off the list to produce God doing something. I rather mean Verse 10, read this. If, Jesus is saying, if you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love. How do we abide in him and in Christ and in his love? By keeping his commandments. Again, I'm not talking about legalism where you have to keep the list or check off the list. No, I mean something else. Let's look at Colossians 3:16, where I believe the Holy Spirit can give you a deeper understanding on how to abide in him. It says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. It talks about dwelling in the word. Letting the word, not just dwelling in it, but letting it dwell in you. Through what? Through just reading it and just knowing a lot? No. Through hymns, through worship, through talking about it, through teaching, listening to teachings, giving teachings, thinking about it, letting it, you know, just be in your heart, singing songs in your heart. That's how you let the word of Christ, his love, himself, his spirit, everything, God himself, dwell in you. That's how you dwell in his word, dwell in his commandments, so to speak. Let's go back to John 15:7, where it says, if you abide in me and in my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. This whole abiding in Christ thing, abiding in his love thing, is intertwined with abiding in his word. How do we abide in Christ? By abiding in his word. Now it says, if you keep my commandments, you will abide in me, you will abide in my love. And it all basically means the same. In my point of view, how I read this, it means the same. If you abide in me, in Christ, and abide in my love, by spending time with me, dwelling in the word, that's the third thing, you will build this relationship, you will build this love level between us. You will spend time with me, we will get to know each other, we will work out things. The love level will rise, the anointing level will rise, and out of it will flow keeping his commandments, which is to, for example, love your neighbor as yourself, loving God even more with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, forgiving others, forgiving your enemy, loving your enemy, praying for your enemy, praying for those that curse you. You know, it will flow out of it when you abide in him in a natural way, in a non-legalistic way that is based on his word and his love. And again, I'm not talking about the huffy fluffy, I just soak in his presence. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about sitting down and saying, you know what, at whatever, 8 o'clock in the morning or whatever, 7 o'clock in the morning, I take my time with God, and I'm taking my time with God. Taking your time out, scheduling time and say, Lord, this is the time that I take for you and you alone. Here I am. Let's work out my struggles. Let's work out these questions. I want to know you. Let's look in the word. What are you saying? Well, you say to love my enemy. Jeez, this one guy I really do not like, and then working it out, and then seeking healing deliverance, forgiving that person, receiving healing deliverance in bitterness, letting bitterness go, and then maybe even discovering that you really can actually love this person and pray for this person, and that it is not about political agendas and political point of views, but it's actually about building the kingdom. And you realize this because you love God and you have spent time with him, and you've spent time in his word, which is so different than the word that the world is giving you, the opinion that the world is giving you every day, all the time, and you realize, Lord, here I am, use me. Do you see what I mean? This keeping his commandments to abide in his love will flow out of dwelling in his word, dwelling in his presence, dwelling in prayer, dwelling in Christ, abiding in Christ. I know this was not a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 step video where I gave you how to exactly in steps, because I don't think this is how it works, and I don't think we should live it out like this. I have to do 1, 2, 3 and then I abide in Christ and Christ abides in me. This is not how it works. Abiding in Christ is loving him, building the love relationship with him, reading his word, and then out of that will flow obedience, which is keeping his commandments through action and prayer, and that's abiding in Christ. Now out of this, automatically, you will see that you will bear fruit, as the Bible says. And I'm going to make another video about this here that you can watch, where I'm explaining how to bear many fruits, or much fruit, as the Bible says. So go ahead, I'll see you in that next video.